Hello everyone and welcome back to the MLG Pro League, where we have Moscow 5 International going up against Album Sheet. Game 1 was a bit of a turnaround. But let's see if Moscow 5 can bring things back and draw this up 1-1, because Album Sheet with one game over them. Definitely showing that they are a very patient team, know how to draw things out that little bit longer than M5, who want to burst in there and do that damage. But heading into the draft, let's also introduce my co-commentator, who hopefully is audible now and for the rest of the game. Slesh, how are you doing?
I'm doing quite well. Well, apart from, you know, missing the first 20 minutes of the first game and then missing the last 10 minutes of, well, I don't
it's
know.
It's fine.
But it's fine. I mean, it's not the first time we are having, well, like Skype call, whatever, audio issues, I suppose. It's just it's a common thing for casters, apparently. So, whatever. The Tusk is not being banned this time around. Axe instead being removed by Moscow 5, and Elven Sheep being forced to remove the Juggernaut themselves. Brewmaster first pick for Moscow 5, so they're really valuing the panda highly. Oh. Let's see how it goes. Magnus vs to, like, Magnus is kind of a trending pick recently, and Album Sheep do pick him up, along with the VS. It's kind of a no-brainer. Witch Doctor second pick is a bit unusual, I think, unless I'm missing something here, but Tusk Nightstalker being banned up at Album Sheet. Once again, very, very common Moscow 5 heroes.
Yep.
And
targeting those bans. That Magnus pick, though, you say it's a bit more popular, but within the CIS region, they pick up Magnus, they buy, what, like Force, Blink Dagger, Force Staff, and then Shadow Blade? They really do play that Magnus in the sneaky role. Try and give him as many ways into those team fights as possible.
Yeah, sometimes you see him on the offlane, sometimes you see him in the mid lane, and it kind of, whenever I see Magnus on the offlane, he struggles really, really hard, because he's just not getting his items up fast enough. But if he's mid, most of the time he starts stomping. And Moscow 5, very smartly removing two heroes that are very, very common being paired up with a Magnus because of the Empower buff-ups. So Anti-Mage and PA, kind of two heroes that like to go for Battle Fury anyway, and there's a certain reason why they do it. Like, with the added cleave from Empower, it just gets sickening. And you also have VS Command Aura on your side as well. Or is it called? It's called Vengeance Aura.
Right
now. Yeah, it's Vengeance Aura right now, yeah. So I'm still kind of old school in that regard, but yeah.
Blue Heroes Strat from Album Sheet, Magnus Puck, Teamfight Lockdown, pretty good AoE abilities, but the majority of their lineup so far is evasiveness. Puck, very good hero at jumping around in team fights. The Illusory Orb and Jaunt, Ventral Spirit, swapping people back or swapping enemies into the rest of the team. Magnus, same kind of story. Once he picks up Blink and Force Staff, Skewer adds that extra option. So it's going to be difficult for M5 to get into these team fights and find pickoffs if Album Sheet are constantly dodging them.
Yeah, and depending on the second support for Moscow 5, it's either Puck offlane or Magnus. Like, one of the two, they can do it interchangeably. So, yep. Which I like a lot. It's always nice to have something that flexible. And Album Sheet, well, if we're going for a blue hero draft, might as well go for Enigma, right? So, Enigma jungle, maybe we see the return. I don't think the blue blob has been picked up recently.
Especially not on the Radiant. He's been picked up a couple of times, Dire side, just because of that movement through the jungle is a little bit smoother. And Radiant side, there's that path from the Dire where they go down their bot lane, smoke up straight through the Radiant jungle, and they just ward up, camp, 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 and they stop the Enigma farming. Whereas Dire side is a little bit more difficult and not as efficient, really, when you're placing sentries and observers to try and block those camps.
Yeah, it's also a longer way, I believe.
Yeah.
It's kind of awkward to walking into there. It's a bit dangerous because you have two cliff sides that you have to go from top rune, which I cannot draw on the map right now, but I think people know what I'm talking about. So
the two blind spots where you go up the ramp.
Yeah, pretty much. That's why, like, Dire Jungle Enigma is a bit safer, although not as efficient. Zeus third pick, okay. That's, am I missing something here?
He's seeing a lot more play, and we've even seen him shift away from that solo mid to sometimes being picked up as a support, and even as a, basically an offlaner. Like, I've seen people play Zeus as an offlane support, where you've got an Axe or someone in the creep wave, and Zeus is just there, 900 range away, ready to do whatever.
Okay, global strat, maybe.
Just a little bit.
I think that's why AS are banning the Ancient Apparition as well. I mean,
it would be
perfect. Yeah, it's otherwise they could run Zeus support and, I don't know, clock offlane.
Well, there's Nature's Prophet still in the pool. Nature's Prophet offlane, potentially. But when you're dealing with a Slark and a Vengeful Spirit, it's a little bit worrisome.
Nah. If they go Nature's Prophet last pick, I'll be very surprised, because the only lockdown they have is Witchdoctor Cask right now. They don't have any second stun. So it's they have no way of dealing with the Slark otherwise. The Slark can just go rampant and across the whole team. At the moment, anyway, I'm liking Alban Sheath's draft a lot more, I have to say.
Well, what is that fifth pick? So you're looking at Slark safe lane. Puck or Magnus, like you said, can switch up off lane or mid. So it will be their second support. But what's it going to be? Rubick?
Is there anything big to... Not really. I don't think there's anything big
there's
to steal.
Zeus ulti, Witch Doctor Cask or Heal, his ulti, Brewmaster, Primal Split. There's quite a lot that you could...
Yeah, Split's nice. Yeah, I gotta admit. That's true.
And Lightning, Lightning Bolt's not bad either.
It's a nice nuke, but I don't know. It's... It kind of feels a bit underwhelming. It's those are all nice spells and everything, but they don't really change the way... like they can't really turn around a teamfight that much. Mm-hmm. I mean, Brewmaster Split being stolen only after he goes back, so most of the time the fight's over already. So, and Zeus, the nukes are nice, but they really don't do that much because you don't have the static field anyway. So, I don't know if Rubick is a good pick here. It's decent. I mean, you can't really fault them if they do go for the Rubick. Otherwise, when we're still in the pool, I mean, Earthshaker still in the pool. Not being played as much. Sand King, also a nice second support. The Beastmaster support? Yeah.
Of course. How could we forget? The CIS scene have loved this a lot, playing that Beastmaster in that sort of holding role, he's not a 1-5 role. Like, he doesn't exist for the first couple of minutes. He's stacking and pulling, and then 10 minutes in, they give him the lane. Let him get level 6, let him get Necro, and then he becomes a fourth core, pretty much.
Well, I think it's basically what... Yeah, it's not a bad pick here. Also, the... Like, the Slark is being buffed so much, though. Like, two auras, one from VS, one from Beastmaster, and then you have Empower on top of it. Like, this Slark's gonna be a beast. Like, I'm really worried for Moscow 5 right now. They need some lockdown. I think something like Skywrath could work well here.
You're probably one of the few people that will remember this, but do you remember Light of Heaven Beastmaster TI1 against eHome?
Yeah, I do.
See, I was mentioning to other people, and they say, oh, I can't remember. But as soon as CIS teams started picking up this Beastmaster in this holding role, I was like, TI1. It's coming back again. We're seeing the same thing come back to us.
Yeah, it's true actually. But Moscow 5, they need some way of dealing with the Slark. It's depending on if they run Zeus support or not. I think they are gonna run him as a core.
Whoa!
And I'm right. They go Lich.
What does the Lich do for you though?
You have a stronger offlane, I suppose. Like Lich, Brewmaster offlane, Zeus mid. Witch Doctor Spectre, and with Alban Sheath, they are not going to go aggro try anyway, because they have Beastmaster support, so they're probably Moscow 5, I was thinking they can get away with it, and they're going to win the lanes, but once again, my point stands, they have no lockdown. It's a really, really big issue. They have no lockdown, and they are terrible at pushing, once again. Spectre doesn't do anything, because you farm Radiance, basically. Zeus doesn't right-click for crap, Brewmaster doesn't either. And neither of the two supports are particularly good. I mean, Witch Doctor is giving some nice sustain with the aura, but I think if Moscow 5 don't win the laning stage convincingly, they're going to have a hard time.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they've got no Hex. Like, that's the one big thing I look for when you're against a Slark. Do you have a Hex? Do you have something that can stop him before he can Dark Pact? Something instant. And there's just nothing on M5 that they have that does that.
Yeah,
They can maybe hope to get him in a Cyclone from the Brew ult and then win the fight like that, take down the rest of Alban Sheath. But it's not going to be easy. Positionally wise, Alban Sheath did really well last game with the Vengeful Spirit constantly standing just far and out of range enough that M5 could never see him. Always ready with a swap. Primal Roar has a pretty long range. He'll be doing the same thing, but on the opposite side. So there's going to be really difficult opportunities for M5 to find openings in these teamfights.
Oh, is that a Ryze? Jason, is that a Ryze?
Yeah,
I think it is. I mean, he's on his Magnus.
Yeah.
that would actually make sense.
So he was playing Ember Spirit last game. I did not realize. Jason is a Ryze, yeah.
Yeah, he is. So, okay, that's good to know. He's on a signature Magnus. And, well, that kind of justifies the first pick Magnus, I suppose.
Yeah, I don't see why not.
I don't see why not, indeed. But at the same time, well, they're calling for the go. He hasn't reconnected back in yet. What the hell?
Maybe he hasn't. It's a bug? I don't know. Unless Lich is going to micro him? I'm not sure.
I don't know what's going on. I mean, somebody's controlling him for sure, or it's just a display bug.
I'm hoping it's a display bug, because he's kind of needed to control his hit. Well, I guess not. Lich can just sacrifice and micro the Brewmaster. It's fine. They're playing 4v5. Yeah, they're giving themselves a challenge.
But they're only one game down, man. I mean, I could understand it if they're one game up, maybe, but... Oh, here, there he is. Okay. They're probably just counting on the fact that he was going to reconnect back in before the creep spawn, so... they're not going to contest the jungle anyway. They have Lich, I mean, so...
He reconnects now as the horn goes.
Yeah. Just in time. It's totally calculated, man. Well, of course. What can I say?
Moscow 5, the kind of team that wants to get the game going, really start things off with a bang. Allowing the game to start without one of their players. Definitely a way to go.
I mean, PGD, I mean, it is an abbreviation for Please Go Game, so yeah. It's... Suppose it makes sense?
Witch Doctor has one last... Did he kill the Hawk? Yeah, he must have killed the Hawk. One last hit on the Witch Doctor. I was wondering, where did he get that from? Yeah. So he's 900 gold. Who got the first two bounty runes? Slark got one, and no one has taken the bot one. Beastmaster just walking past it?
That's odd.
Usually we see both teams fighting over control for at least one of the runes each.
Yeah. And neither of the two teams were doing it. They weren't even doing some deep warding. I mean, we have one standard ward from the Radiant blocking the pull camp, but... okay.
ZXC?
Taking... Yeah.
It looks like he'll be fine. They throw out the cask. Actually, he goes back in. ZXC, have you disconnected or something? What are you doing?
Oh, VS has no stun. Okay. He went for Howl, level 1. Okay, that's probably why I was... But still, I mean, trading hits with the Slark, does he have more regen or something? No, he doesn't.
Slark has the poor man shield as well, so it's not like you're going to win that trade regardless of what goes on.
No, maybe he was just trying to, you know, get something going before Slark has level 2 and then
mind games.
His essence shift.
He's playing the mind games. Well, he's gone for Desolate after the dagger, so they can slow him down, do damage like this over time. That Orb of Venom definitely helping slow down the Slark. And PGG going to be looking to pull this camp... It's going to be too late, though. The creep waves will already meet.
Yeah, I mean, it's dual lanes from both sides, so Magnus against Yu's mid is kind of an even matchup, just both heroes farm, so...
Well, it's both heroes spamming their spells as long as they can, buying clarities and bottle and stuff.
It's basically who's more efficient with bottle crowning. That's everything there is. Or you get, I don't know, like Lucky Hastron into... I don't know. DD or something, I suppose.
DD for the mag. Haste for the Zeus. Just keep on chasing. There's going to be a bounty rune at top lane. The Beastmaster took that bounty rune and now takes the invis. So he's sitting on level 2.
That's nice. We shouldn't I mean, it's going to be a fairly passive laning phase, I think. Like both teams, just dual lanes on dual lanes with no strong killing potential. But I mean, I was annoyed at the fact they had nothing for the Slark, but the same can be said for the Puck, though. Like, you don't have any silence to deal with
the Slark is going on PGG up a top lane, stealing all of those stats. He's going to take first blood here.
Yeah.
Brings down PGG and turns back on ZXC, gets stunned up by the magic missile from the Ventral Spirit, keeps on going. The Essence Shift, stacking up that agility. Two more hits, I think. No, one more with a Ventral Spirit.
Yeah. That's bad.
Quick and easy. M5, looking like they're in a bit of trouble here.
Yeah, M5, and they're really not looking too good. And bot lane's not doing... I mean, of course, they're doing 9 XP and farm, but... Puck still keeping up in terms of CS anyway, and Beastmaster is spending half of his time in the jungle anyway. No big issue there. I think they have to really crush bot lane if they want to... Because mid lane is break even, as we already mentioned, so... And top lane is a disaster right now.
But what kind of item build does this Zeus go for? Because there's nothing really he can go that's game-changing. And we sort of usually see the Arcane, Sol Ring, maybe Blink Dagger, Yule Scepter. But there's nothing there that can turn things around.
No, I think he probably... Judging by the way the game's going, he probably needs to go for an early 4-star, really. Otherwise, Puck jumps you and you're dead. And there's nothing you can do about it.
But then up against the Slark, full staff's not going to do too much. If the Slark jumps you...
Well, if he... Yeah.
Like this, onto PGG's, jumping already. Is he going to throw the cask? He's got the Voodoo Restoration, but Mantis still stealing those stats. He's got Pounce off cooldown in 8 seconds, and he's got the Dark Pack to go as well. Spectre
is... VS
is
going to die,
though. I found the Spectre, chasing that VS down. Mantis doesn't find the kill on PGG. So ZXC finding a nice kill there. Onto the Vengeful Spirit. Does he chase? Dagger, level 2, thrown out.
He's dead.
He needs one hit. It's level one Desolate. Is he going to find it though? Can he make up the distance? He's still chasing. He needed two hits. The creep wave. The creep wave stopping the Desolate attack, but he still finds it. Vengeful Spirit, Big Numb coming in. Wave of Terror. Stun under the tower. The tower's going to finish him off.
Well, that's nice. That's instant level four for the VS. But it could have gone a lot worse for Moscow 5. I think it's just Mantis got a bit ahead of himself and just really wanted the kill on Witch Doctor instead of protecting the VS. Because VS still had stun up, so he survived for a fairly decent amount of time. I think if Sly would have stayed and started hitting on the Spectre instead, he might have been able to at least scare the Spectre away, but...
Yeah.
I mean...
I think Mantis missed his second pounce as well on the Witch Doctor or something, because PGG survived a long time. Level 2 Voodoo Restoration is pretty good, but up against the Slark, who's stealing all of your stats with Essence Shift, pretty difficult to deal with.
Indeed.
And last hit-wise, Magnus is beating the Zeus. 29 from 19, so starting to rack up a nice early lead.
And he's got stacks as well, does he? No, he doesn't, but he can. You can always still shockwave the big cap, so even if it's not going too well, it's the power of Radiant mid-Magnus or like Radiant mid-SF or something on those lines.
Or mid-Lycan.
You can always catch up. Or mid-Lycan.
It's pretty much mid any hero that can take out jungle camps.
Yeah. But it's overall Magnus having a really significant lead there against the Zeus, and in the moment he's kind of low HP, he's waiting for the bottle to come back, which is happening right now, and yeah. It's an even matchup, and we just apparently top lane is the place to watch.
Well, what about bot lane? Beastmaster guarding that rune sends the boar forward so the Brewmaster can't contest.
That's nice. Oh, they do have a jungle stack there for the Magnus. That's nice. It's been stacked two times, so yeah.
Or is it for the Puck? Because Puck bringing a bottle to himself slows down his blink dagger just a little bit, but gives him that lane sustain, keeps those orbs going.
He's got, I mean, Orb of Venom Puck? Is that a thing now? I
don't know. Up against the Lich, I guess it's not bad. He can just constantly harass the Lich and send him back to base, which he's done now. But I don't know, how much is Orb of Venom? 175?
It's more than that, isn't it?
It's 225 now, isn't it?
It's 225.
275 even.
Yeah, oh my God. I think it's more, yeah. I don't know if it's worth it, because the slow is kind of negligible. I mean, it's 4%, please.
On a ranged hero, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of iffy.
Zeus has come up to top lane, looking for Mantis. The stun from the Witch Doctor pounces away. Can they finish him off? There's the Bolt and the Chain Lightning. They bounce right back onto the Slark. And they're going to find Big Numb as well, the Desolate attack. Dealing out the damage. Magic Missile not going to save you from the Lightning Bolt of Zeus. So nice quick rotation there. And I was going to make the point that with this lead Magnus has with gold and experience over the Zeus, then M5 aren't making up for it anywhere. There was no advantage they're gaining elsewhere, but with that one move, definitely bringing things back.
The value Invis rune, what can I say?
Yep.
And also incredibly good timing, because Slark was not level 6 yet. And the VS kind of, I think his death was really unnecessary, because
he just walked into it.
Yeah, I mean, there was no way you could have saved the Slark at this point, and it's kind of a very common occurrence. You see it very, very often, you know, like support heroes trying to save their cores and dying in the process.
I think the AC calls it save your buddy syndrome. I've started using that phrase as well. Get into that mindset where you think, I'm a support, I've got to go and save him.
Yeah.
Whoa, yeah, Mag. 50 gold away from Blink, 8 minutes in.
Yeah, he took out the stack, so giving Beastmaster a little bit of XP, but then again, he picks up the region, and so where's Zeus? Zeus is going back to base, the region and up, and we still don't really see what he's going to go for. I know some Zeus players actually like the Midas on the hero, and then try to just get rack up farm and XP, and
we've seen that from
angle for the late game.
From Phobos, he goes Midas BKB.
Yeah, it's kind of a standard fight Zeus build.
When he goes for Staff of Wizardry, so it could be Yules, could be 4 Staff. Don't know quite sure what we're looking at yet, though.
Yeah, I think an early 4 Staff can be really nice in this game. I don't know if Yules is going to do too much.
Oh, wow, Beastmaster, where did you go?
Yeah.
The Lich Frost Blast with a level 4 Lightning Bolt. Beastmaster went from full HP to 0 instantly.
Yeah. Yeah,
RP up on top lane on ZXC, pounce from the Slark, there's no escape from this, Wave of Terror finishing him off.
Yeah.
Instant reaction now, PGG with the Cask and the Death Ward. Does he have enough damage though? The bounces are so damn lucky. Are you serious?
And buyback from the Spectre, and it seems to be worth it. He's got another dagger. Is he gonna continue chasing? No. The boar is just so obnoxious.
Quick turnaround there. M5. Looking pretty good all of a sudden.
Yeah.
What did they actually gain?
I was really doubting it, but... Oh, Beastmaster, please, man. It's a level 8 Lich. He hurts.
Where's the Orb of Venom on Lich, though? If only he had it.
I don't even think that would have got him the kill, though.
Come on. You have to believe. Believe in the ranged Orb of Venom.
Believe in the oof, as the UI likes to say.
No.
No,
please.
Yeah. It's gonna be a 4-star for this use. That's okay. Nice. I think it's a nice thing.
Close. Very close.
That was kind of unfortunate. Like, if he would have been stuck up there, Magnus could just stay there and start spraying Shockwave until Zeus is dead, basically.
Well, he's got... Zeus has TP, so he could have escaped.
Yeah.
I mean, I was looking at Magnus, seeing if he had RP, and if the Zeus tried to TP out, then Mag RPs from the bottom of the cliff. That would have been pretty funny.
Yeah, you could...
They're looking at top lane, though. Magic Missile and the Dream Coil onto ZXC. Tries to dagger away, gets into the trees. The Beastmaster says no. Clears them down with his wild axes. So this Spectre not having a great time. Phase Boots?
No.
Wraith Band?
He's having a terrible time. He bought back, remember?
Yeah.
So...
What's Magnus doing?
He's still thinking that his use is up there, but come on, man. That would have been really unlikely. Like, they didn't have a ward.
Do they not have vision up there? They do, with the Radiant Ward. They've got vision over there. Well...
Yeah, but he was a bit more to the right, though.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not doing too much. He's just waiting one Blink Dagger cool.
Slander bot lane. He can't even pop Primal Split.
He can TP.
Very true. While top lane, Puck gonna have to jaunt away into the trees. Spectre with a dagger gonna scout him out. TP there. Chain Frost cancelling it. No TP for you, Mr. Puck.
Yeah. Spectre spending a little bit of time there. I mean, he will be forced to use his
dagger to get
Spectre
out.
Spectre dagger. Yeah, it's kind of annoying. I mean, they gave him one arcane boot, so it's fine. It's not too bad. Magnus, meanwhile, is he gonna? I don't know. What does Arise normally buy in terms of boots on Magnus? Does he buy treads or does he buy arcanes?
I don't know. I occasionally see people buy arcanes on Magnus, but only if you're either really, really far ahead, or a little bit far behind. So you need that stopgap item just so you can keep spamming out Shockwave. Usually you just see them keep brown boots. You go Blink Force and that gives you enough mana pool to keep things going. You've got the mobility then. And then you consider going into things like Treads, Boots of Travel.
Smoke up from the two of them, and there's a hasted Magnus as well. So Spectre, he can't risk dying again. Man, that would be really annoying. But there's a Hawk. I don't know if they saw the Hawk. I don't think they do. So... Wishlock, they might be the one who's tanking the gank. But I don't think they're going to be happy with it. They really want the Spectre.
Poor old BGG. He's going to get Dream Called and Skewered. They don't need the RP to be expended there, but big TP's in here from M5. They've got Primal Split.
Do they have Blink? They don't have Blink on Panda. Why is he TPing in?
I don't know. There's no way to close the distance. He just TPs up here, hits a couple of creeps, then he's going to back off.
Zeus TP'd as well. He's got an Invis rune, once again, value Invis, but I think Beastmaster might die here because they are banning him. I think he's dead.
650 HP. What does Zeus need? One Bolt, one Ulti, and Chain Frost, Chain Lightning? If they have a Lich run forward, they can Frost Blast him.
He needs a second Lightning Bolt. So I don't think... He doesn't know who's behind him, though, and Beastmaster now seeing the Creep Wave coming. That's not going to work. Unfortunate, but still. Well, Puck is kind of close to his Blink Dagger. That one death was really annoying, but he needs 300 gold more, roughly, and he's going to have it.
And then they've got the double threat.
Yeah.
And that should give Mantis enough time to start building up his items. He's gone for a Bracer as sort of a stopgap. I don't know if he's looking for drums or if that is just a naked Bracer. Then you go into something like the Blink or the Shadow Blade. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Mid lane, Slander blinking in after Zeus has died. Primal Split used. Spectral Dagger thrown out, but... Are they still chasing this? Big Numb is getting hammered by those Primal Splits. And then a stun from Witch Doctor. Mantis just goes invisible. M5 here, throwing spells, but not really connecting. And now Mantis jumps forward. Nice, big Dream Coil, catching three. Primal Roar onto the Witch Doctor, but the Chain Frost bouncing between them. There's Creep Wave to soak it up. The Ventral Spirit goes, the Beastmaster goes down. The Ventral Spirit shortly following after. And Jason Arise missing the skewer. Slander going to accept his fate regardless.
It's all because Mantis missed the pounce. I think the Dream Call was really nice, but Mantis missed two pounces once again, so they couldn't get the kill on the Witch Doctor fast enough. It was kind of annoying, but still, I mean, they come out even, and I think if they, as long as they are coming out even, it's fine, really. I think they have the stronger late game overall, really. Moscow 5, they are not very good at forcing objectives. That being said, Alvashi's not doing too much of that themselves. Like, there's no single tier 1 tower down yet.
Yeah, it was kind of weird engagement from M5, just throwing spells everywhere, not really hitting anyone in particular, but it turned out to be okay for them. Let's actually take a quick look at the graphs and see how things are going. It's pretty much dead even in net worth.
Yeah.
M5 lost a little bit of a lead, but after a pretty rough laning phase, it wasn't a lead they particularly deserved. Yeah. XP-wise, a slight advantage for M5, 2,000, but nothing to write home about.
Top lane, they're diving onto the Beastmaster, and they should be able to get the kill as well. And wow, Puck is taking a lot of damage there from the Witch Doctor just before he's getting out.
He face shifts that Thunder God's Wrath though, they take down the Witch Doctor, it's a one-for-one trade.
That was kind of lucky, I have to say.
Yeah, because he was face shifting to jaunt away. It wasn't like his, oh, I'm gonna die.
Yeah. That was, I mean, in the end, two ultis being expended and two supports trading lives. It's
not a big
once
deal.
Again, it should be no big deal, really. Big Num? Oh, that's not nice. Spectre's gonna haunt in, and
he doesn't have a dagger. Still gonna get a hit off, though. Paying for it with his life.
I don't know if that was worth it.
We were looking at the trade before, thinking, oh, this is even, pretty much. And then all of a sudden, Spectre runs in and dies. Now, Mantis has gone for a Midas here, not going for the Shadow Blade or the Blink Dagger. He wants to try and get a little bit more gold, take this a bit later, knowing the Spectre has nothing whatsoever. Do you think this is the right choice?
I think it's okay. They already have two Blinks on Puck and Magnus, so they don't really need a second, third Blink, sorry. And I think the Midas is a good pickup overall. Oh, RP and cancelling the TP at the same time as well, and Mantis is not going to miss that pounce.
There's no way you can miss that. Zeus is stunned and skewered right into his face.
Yeah. But that, are you seeing what I'm seeing? This Lich is pretty damn stacked, man. Level 11, mech in Tranquil Boots.
That's ridiculous.
This Lich is he's really, really fat. He hasn't died yet, mind you.
Compare the Lich to the Brewmaster. Brewmaster's level 10. Sure, he's going to hit level 11 after, what, another creep wave and a half, or if he goes into the jungle. But Brew has Blink. How far away are they from net worth? 3,700 on the Lich? 5,000 on the Brewmaster? I guess there's a bit of a disparity there. But still, this is a support Lich who was off the lane the majority of the game.
Yeah.
He was just standing at the tier 1 tower using Sacrifice, running back to base, getting harassed by the Puck.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive. And then again, at the moment, Arise, he's not really, I mean, there are no big team fights really, that's why he's using RP the whole time for pickoffs, and bot lane, I think they are going to defend that tower, and I think Slander realizing something fishy is up, because suddenly nobody's showing on the map.
And also, Puck is standing pretty aggressively, even with that Brewmaster Blink Collapse split.
They really want that tower, but as I said, they're not very good at taking those.
Well, Slanta wants Mantis at mid. They go in there, the Dark Pact, and then the Shadow Dance from Slark, allowing him to escape.
Oh, Big Nong's being chased. Is he going to use the Chain Frost? Yeah, to cancel the TP. That's fine.
Beastmaster killed the Witch Doctor in the back end as the rest of the Radiant are chasing down. RP on cooldown for 7 seconds, but they don't need it to finish off the Lich.
So it's a 2-for-1 trade, and Mantis getting the last hit now, which is really, really nice. So suddenly up to 1,400 gold, with drums and Midas, so I don't even know if he's going to go for Blink this game.
No. You just go straight into Skadi, I think, here.
I think so too, yeah.
You mentioned it in the draft, he's got the Beastmaster Aura, Venge Aura, he's got Empower from the Magnus, he's got plenty of attack speed, damage. I think he just needs to stack up HP.
Yeah. Bot tower is probably going to get denied, I don't think Puck can take it. Brewmaster just wait. Yeah, he's just waiting until it's out of sight.
This is Russian Dota. You never know what's going to happen.
Like, no, all Bios is, yeah, all of a sudden blink forward, orbit, yep, and try to get the last hit. Yeah.
I would not be surprised at all. Like, I'd be expecting that. But it wasn't to be. Puck TPing back to base.
Yeah, it would be fun to see, though. At least the good thing for Moscow 5 is they're leaving the Spectre alone. So he's farming, quietly farming his Relic. But should he die in the next 5 minutes, it's going to set him back really badly. So maybe we're going to see a Ryze solo RP once again and trying to kill the Spectre. But I think at the moment they're just content farming up Mantis instead, and they know that he's really far ahead, and they have a big-ass stack to work through.
Yeah, and the fact that Mantis can beat that Spectre in a 1v1, the Slark does very well up against that.
Zeus ulti being used for scouting, so they know that they are currently at the Ancients, and Mantis is not having too much fun. They're very, very quick blink out from the Ryze on the Magnus. Nice reactions. I think he was expecting it as well, though. And M5, they're gonna try it. They want to contest the Ancient camp, but they have nobody who can actually take it out reliably.
Well, PGG is gonna have a go.
Well, good luck with that, mate.
You can never say PGG doesn't try.
He is trying, constantly.
Yep.
Succeeding is another meta entirely, but hey.
And then he's retrying, and re-re-retrying, and re-re-retrying.
I don't even know how many TRR teams there have been.
Seven or something. Primal Split used a Ryze.
That was awkward.
Skewers up on top of the cliff. Spectre using the ultimate, trying to chase down the puck possibly. I don't know who they're looking for here.
It's kind of awkward.
Who have they gone in on? They went in on the puck. Who just blinked back?
They just used two ultis for nothing. They're not even going to get an objective. They can't push the tower. So Brewmaster split down and Haunt is down.
But more importantly, the Spectre came to the fight. So that's farming time gone.
Yeah, I mean, he's gonna rotate bot and probably try to force a few TPs, but yeah.
PGG.
That's a nice attempt at a Witch Doctor when there are four heroes surrounding you, but.
What a guy.
What a guy. Oh, they're gonna. Yeah, fine. Might as well.
Yeah, you may as well, Glyph. it doesn't accomplish anything really, like it slows them down for 3 seconds, but.
Well, it's making sure that Mantis is getting the last hit, I suppose.
Yeah.
3k gold up suddenly on Slark, and what are you gonna do with this? I mean, as I said, they have no way, they have no hero that actually counters the Slark, and that's just something that Mantis is gonna love. He doesn't even need to hit pouncers, I think, he just needs to right-click people.
Yeah, you just run at people at this point.
Yeah.
Do you even need to save for buyback on Mantis? I guess you do kind of blink forward. RP cancelled, skewering back, not catching anyone. Here's the RP onto two, the Brewmaster and the Lich. Can he get the Chain Frost in time? Doesn't look like he can. The Primal Roar, Slander on the Brewmaster already goes down. Meanwhile on bot lane, Puck finding a kill on the Spectre. Slark kills the Lich.
Who killed the VS?
Who did kill the VS?
Zeus killed her. With an ulti, I suppose?
He was
bot lane. Oh yeah, they were fighting the Spectre, and yeah, then the Spectre was probably fighting back, and then Zeus uses ulti, VS dies, so.
Not sure if intentional, but I guess the Spectre would have called for it.
Yeah, that's still annoying though, 3.4k gold. I think you would have had the Relic otherwise. So, he's still gonna get a decent time considering the way the game's going, really. I mean, as long as you get Radiance before minute 25, it's really good, I think, still. I don't know if he's gonna be able to get it before minute 25, probably not, more like 27, 28, but yeah.
Well, we're looking at Album Sheet taking now a 7,000 gold lead in terms of net worth over M5 experience, same kind of story. And at this point, after winning in the early laning stage, the first, 4 or 5 minutes, then M5 coming back, and now Album Sheet taking the lead back from them, it looks like Album Sheet have taken that last step. They've got the Slark farm, they've got their initiation, all they need now is to execute. They don't really need any big item. They're not waiting for something to happen.
Mantis went for the Shadow Blade, by the way, instead. Yeah. I suppose it's nice for her, so Spectre feels really, really threatened pushing out by herself, so.
Not just that, he can go hunting the Witch Doctor of the Lich, actually, in mid lane. Primal Roar, Slander, can he get his split off? Does he need to? Doesn't look like he will, there's no targets to go for. And ZXC coming in here, haunting in with the Spectral Dagger.
Did you see that?
Blink clap, missing completely.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yes.
RP onto two, though. Here's a Ryze and a blink pounce from Mantis, catching them. The empowered Slark, dealing out so much damage, and Brewmaster looking for a target, trying to find one. They find the Beastmaster with the help of Zeus and Spectre.
I don't think Spectre's gonna die, though.
You don't? Magic Missile, Mantis, pounce, killed. Another Zeus might die. Shadowblade.
Zeus is gonna die, I think.
Pounce off in 2 seconds. 1 second. There's the pounce. Kills him and the Brewmaster. Mantis unstoppable with a double kill.
Yeah.
Album Machine.
They lose two, but it's the two supports. Who cares?
Yeah. Well, Album Machine had that lead we were just talking about, and they didn't need to make the move. They didn't need to get a big item. M5 are the ones who feel like they're pressured on the back foot. Spectre putting that Radiance on the back burner. Might even need to change it up and go for a different item here.
I think he's still going to stubbornly go for the Redic. I don't think he's going to need it. Right at this point, I think Moscow, they have to realize, boys, we can't fight anymore. We are losing. It's once again the same story as the last game. I hope they are more patient this time around. They have to get the Spectre fat. It's the only way of dealing with the Slug. Just try to out-carry the Slug, which is kind of impossible, but I mean, you can give it a go. I mean, Zeus does scale quite nicely into late game.
I just worry, though, because the Zeus looks like he's going for a Bloodstone. He went for the Sol Ring early, and then he's got a point booster.
I think it's an Agnum. Like, if he's going for Bloodstone, then I don't know.
I've seen Bloodstone a lot from Zeus, but I don't even think Agnums is the right choice. You need a Hex. He's going to get roared, nuked, silenced. Well, nothing can save him there.
Yeah. At this point, it's already paying off that they're running support Beastmaster because they can just expend roars the whole time.
Yeah, he's got Blink Roar.
Yeah.
What else do you need?
Oh, that's a Dead Lich.
Where is he? Oh, Mantis finding another kill. He's got Shadow Dance.
You can turn around and just kill PGG. Yeah, there we go. As I said, you have no way of dealing with this Slug. There's nothing you can do. You have no heroes to deal with it. That's why I said, it's even if Moscow 5 slightly come on ahead in the laning phase, which they didn't, by the way, they still can't deal with the Slug if he gets fat. It's just the nature of the lineup. I think last game was not a drafting issue, but this game I think it really was. I think the draft was really weak.
Like, they had this gimmicky idea where the Brewmaster and Lich sit bot, and they've got the basically two semi-cores on that bot lane. But the Zeus breaking even with the Magnus, not really giving them an advantage there. The Spectre, he has Relic. They've got something.
Yeah,
but can they actually fall back on it?
There's a full Skadi flying in on the Courier.
No.
Just want to mention that.
No!
And there is an Aegis as well, I might add. So, yeah, like I don't even know why they're giving it to the Slark, really. I think they can just give it to the Magnus instead. I don't think Slark's gonna die at all.
Well, Slark can just go in now and try and 1v5 at the fountain.
I suppose it's a valid strat.
Yeah. And then the rest of your team wanders around and takes Ancients or something. Ignore towers, there's no point in taking them. Like, Mantis, what are you doing? Surely this isn't where you want to go.
Yeah. He doesn't even want to get the last hit at this point. more of gold for everyone else. He's farmed enough as it is. He's more than double the net worth of the Spectre, so... is that a... Oh, Spectre, you better get... Oh, he has no TP.
Yeah, he's dead. Pounce from Mantis. Not even needed.
As I said, you don't really need it. It doesn't matter. He just needs to get, in the general direction and then attack move.
Yep.
And he's fine. There's nothing else he needs to do, really.
Get into the trees, attack move.
Yeah.
Then press the G's.
Yeah. At some point, right-click and change direction, maybe, but hey. It's nothing else you need to do at this point. It's a very comfortable game to be playing Slark right now. You're way more farmed than the whole enemy team. And you can just run random. They have no counters. They have no hard lockdown. They have no silence.
They have PGG, who is giving even more gold to Mantis, who's now on a godlike streak.
Yeah, I mean, what to do?
And now they blink forward, arise, skewering the Zeus back.
Yeah.
That's...
Ryze is playing quite nicely on the signature Magnus, but at this point it doesn't even really matter. He can, they can afford to solo RP the Lich or the Witch Doctor, and it doesn't matter.
At this point, it's the Mantis show. Swap back, big numb. Catching screen, nuking him down, slander, silence, stop, can't get the problem split. We'll clap and split now, Mantis. In no trouble whatsoever. Even if he died, he could respawn.
Yeah, but they are not going to kill him the first time. It's pretty much impossible.
They might kill Avenge, though. She's got 1200 HP, actually. A more difficult prospect than at first it seemed.
Yeah, but 8 armor, man. And Slander now coming back in, and... Well, at least they got the puck, I suppose. That's nice.
The puck jumping forward.
Yeah. That's a nice cast bouncing there. It's not hitting a Ryze though, which is the hero they want to get.
That was a really long range death ward.
Yep.
Like, PGG, is that some kind of hack?
I don't know.
He was standing by this tree and he puts one down outside of his base out here. I don't know. Maybe he placed it on the cliff and it clipped over or something. It just looked a bit odd.
Yeah. Who knows, really? Puck dying and while he's dead buys a full Aghanim Scepter or whatever, you know.
I've got the gold to spend. Ryze. Oh. Cancelling the RP. But Mantis on the front lines, taking down the tier 3.
He's got Shadowblade, he's got ulti.
He's gonna die to Maledict, though. No?
No, he's not. He's reaching against it.
Wow. Level 3 Shadow Dance, way too much.
Yeah, 173 per second. You can't really out-damage that. PGG, please.
Wait, I've got to zoom in on this. Mantis, hello? Gets taken out anyway.
I mean, at this point, it really doesn't matter. I might as well give him another kill. He's feeling pretty good about himself. He's missing, uncharacteristically, probably, missing a lot of pounces, but it just doesn't matter. He's got 5k gold again. You can just probably buy a full Abyssal Blade at some point. Yeah, there's a Basher. There we go. Necroman. Oh, Slug sees him. That's bad.
What's he even doing this far down the lane? It's not as though he needs to put momentum down this lane because that's already happening, really.
I think Moscow 5 are just in full tilt right now. after losing, ever since, you know, getting turned around in game 1, they just look like a bit out of sorts. Which is just unfortunate. I mean, but would have liked to see a closer game 2, but it's just not happening right now.
Album Machine, Dream Call onto 2, the Spectre getting caught out. Here's the Chain Frost bouncing between Hawk and no one. Because Mantis is now invisible, going onto the Lich, finding him. PGG, second to fall. Witch Doctor ult, Death Ward is placed. Mantis can respawn though, if he dies. When he dies, will he die? Mantis is still surviving, he's alive, he's not dying. He survived on like 50 HP or something, but regardless.
No more Maledict, so yeah. Then Panda dies. Well, how many stacks does he have?
Many.
Yeah, 63 utility.
That's quite a bit. Good game, well played. Moscow 5 losing at 2-0 up against Album Sheet, who put up a dominant performance as Primal Roar. They look to take down the Spectre. Nope, not quite enough. But we'll be back shortly. I've been Durker, joining me Slesh. We're coming back in a short while. How long, in fact, until 4ASC up against NIP? That should be happening 12 minutes ago, actually. So we'll have to run over there, find that game, and we'll be back in a couple of minutes.